The COMELEC official in charge of writing the draft resolution on the consolidated disqualification cases against presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. makes a point-by-point rebuttal of allegations made by fellow Commissioner Rowena Guanzon. Guanzon claimed on Thursday that Commissioner Amy Ferolino is likely being influenced by a powerful politician, most likely a senator, to delay the resolution until after Guanzon retires on February 2 this year.
This unreasonable and malicious delay for me is because there is really an intention to defeat my vote. I think there's somebody very powerful that's backing her up. Because, you know, she's a new commissioner. She's not practiced law in the court, so she's not, you know, trained in writing decisions or pleadings.
But in a letter to COMELEC Chairman Sheriff Abbas, dated January 28, Ferolino says there was no internal agreement among First Division members to release the decision on January 17. And she and Commissioner Marlon Casquejo only knew of the alleged unilaterally imposed deadline on Guanzon's Twitter page. Ferolino argued it was impossible to resolve the cases based on that timeline because she only received the evidence and other records for the cases on January 14. The three consolidated Marcos petitions were raffled to her office on January 10. Ferolino also said Guanzon is trying to influence her decision. On Thursday, Guanzon revealed she voted to disqualify Marcos because of moral turpitude when he did not file his income tax returns for 4 years as governor of Ilocos Norte. Ferolino also asked COMELEC to review Guanzon's interviews and social media posts that named her as the ponente, which she said posed a threat to her safety and security. Ferolino vowed to craft an impartial resolution on the complex case and says her office is doing its best so the commission will not be placed in a bad light. Ferolino initially declined to respond to Guanzon's allegations, invoking the sub judice rule, but her letter to Abbas seems to show a change of heart. Ina Reformina, ABS-CBN News.